I've been out over a month from wrestling. I've lost about 10 pounds of muscle mass, and I don't even want to wrestle. My mind is with my family. But I go back to practice because my mom wants me there. So for the first few days, my team leaves me alone. I'm just kind of in a slump. I'm not wrestling well. I'm struggling. So they kind of leave me alone, let me do my own thing. But one day, my coach thinks, okay, he's been in a slump long enough. I need to snap him out of it. So he makes me wrestle my backup, thinking I just need a confidence booster. My backup and I wrestle 5 matches in a row, and all 5 matches, he just destroys me. Just beats me up, throws me around. 6th match, I'm wrestling again. Now, all my teammates are watching. They're sitting against the wall, watching me get beat again. Coach is just yelling at me. He's just screaming at me as I'm getting beat up. So in my mind, I'm thinking, okay, I need to turn it around right here. I gotta take control, I gotta win this match, I'm coming back. So with everything I had, we call it a shot. I went in for a shot. So I reached in for my opponent's leg to try to take him down. As I reached, he locked up underneath my arms. His hands are like this behind my back. So he locks up, throws me in the air, slams me down on my back. His shoulder lands square in the center of my chest, knocks the wind out of me. So I remember I'm laying there, and as a wrestler, we know what we're supposed to do when we're on a back. You fight off. Doesn't matter if the match is over, if you're hurt, if you're tired, you fight off your back. That's what we're taught. We say it as a pride. You know, ultimate sign of weakness is if you lay on your back. We think you're quitting. So I know what I'm supposed to do. I know I need to fight, but I just remember telling myself, I'm done fighting. I remember telling myself, it's too hard, I can't do it anymore. And I closed my eyes, and I got pinned. So my coach blows his whistle, I open my eyes up. He's staring right down at me as I'm laying there. He stares down at me, he said, we made a big mistake giving you that scholarship. He said, if you want to quit, there's a door, we don't need you anymore. And you know, I remember just standing up, just walking out of that locker room crying, just tears coming down my face. And I go out, start packing my things, and I start walking out the door. He stops me, grabs my bag, and throws it on the ground. And I'm thinking he's gonna start yelling at me some more, right? So I put my head down, I just brace for him to start screaming. But he doesn't yell at me. So I'm looking down for a little bit, I'm waiting for him, still not yelling. I look up at him, and my eyes are all just watery. You know, I'm biting my lip, feel that tennis ball in my throat. I'm looking up at him right in the face, and he's staring at me, and he just gives me this big hug, just squeezes me. And I literally just start weeping right there, just crying. And he didn't know about my mom's situation. So I told him everything. I told him what was going on. And he said something to me. It wouldn't sink in just yet, but it would shortly after that. He said, look, he said, you know, I don't know how hard it is for you right now. He said, but you got to remember something. You're always going to be challenged with something. He said, you're always going to face a hard time. You're always going to get tired. He says, you're going to face those rough times where, you know, you're not sure if you're capable of going through it. He says, but during that time, you got to ask yourself, how am I going to react? You can't feel sorry for yourself. He says, you got to grind through this. You got to push. He said, that's how you get to the top. He said, you go home, you think about that. If you want to come back, we want you here. He said, but only if you, mentally, if you believe in yourself. And so he sent me home, and it honestly didn't sink in just yet. But when I'm sitting at home in my apartment alone, I'm thinking, I want to be there because I want to support my teammates, I want to wrestle hard for them, and my mom wants me here. You know, I don't want to let my mom down. I don't want to be a quitter. My mom didn't raise a quitter. I'm not going to quit.